Hybridization and shape of atoms with lone pairs. It's important for us to consider all of the things that surround an atom when we look at its hybridization and decide upon the hybridization and the shape. This is in particular true in organic chemistry when we're looking at molecules that contain nitrogen and oxygen. To illustrate this, I want to look at two different molecules, one containing nitrogen and one containing oxygen. The nitrogen-containing molecule that we're going to look at is methylamine, and the oxygen-containing molecule that we're going to look at is methanol. Focusing first on the methylamine, you'll notice that there are three different atoms around nitrogen, so a lot of times it's intuitive to consider nitrogen to have some sort of trigonal shape like this, almost trigonal planar, the way we've drawn it and the way we've talked about hybridization before. If we look at the actual structure of this nitrogen-containing molecule, however, we see this. We can see the carbon of the methylamine is tetrahedral, exactly the way we expected. It's got four atoms bonded to it, a hydrogen, a hydrogen, a hydrogen, and then our nitrogen. Four groups, we expect tetrahedral. The nitrogen has three atoms bonded to it, but you'll notice it's not trigonal planar sp2. It has sort of a pyramidal shape to it, where we've got the nitrogen above a plane of three atoms. And the reason for that is, of course, that the nitrogen has lone pairs on it. And often we forget those lone pairs. We can visualize them in this case if we want to. In this example, the lone pairs are represented by the pink sphere, and they occupy the fourth place in our hybridization around the nitrogen, indicating clearly that the nitrogen is sp3 hybridized and explaining the shape that we see. And it's important for us to remember this. I can do the same thing for methanol. In this case, I've replaced my nitrogen with an oxygen. We still have our tetrahedral sp3 hybridized carbon bonded to three hydrogens and one oxygen. And you'll notice that even though the oxygen is only bonded to two other atoms, it is in a bent shape around this oxygen. And we can explain this if, again, we look at the lone pairs. This time the oxygen has two lone pairs, and you can see they occupy the third and fourth position around that oxygen, again indicating why that oxygen is sp3 hybridized, and giving us the bent shape for this group right here. It's always important for us to consider the lone pairs when we're deciding about the shape we predict and expect around an atom.